हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई रिश्रा मैदानी वेलकम बैक टू यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ गुरु केपीओ। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ सर्किट एलिमेंट्स टू एसी वोल्टेज सोर्स। वी ऑल नो द मेन बेसिक थ्री एलिमेंट्स ऑफ आर एसी वोल्टेज सोर्स आर रजिस्टर, इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर। वी विल डिस्कस ईच वन बाय वन। सो स्टार्ट विद रजिस्टर। हियर वी हैव विद अस एसी थ्रू प्योर रजिस्टेंस। Now we have a circuit in which we connect a resistor through a voltage source, which is a sinusoidal voltage source. So the voltage will be V is equals to Vm sin omega t. Now this is our supply voltage, V is equals to Vm sin omega t. So the RMS value of the voltage is Vm by under root 2. Now when we will connect a resistor through a voltage source, there will be a current flow in the circuit, current I, and the value of current I will be I is equals to V by R. We all know that. Now putting the value of voltage, Vm sin omega t by R. Now this value Vm by R becomes Im. Im is the peak value of current, and here Vm is equals to the peak value of our voltage. So I is equals to Im sin omega t. Here we can see that the voltage and current are in same phase. So the value of I becomes I is equals to Im by under root 2 I RMS value. So here we can see that there is no phase angle between current and voltage. They are in same phase. So we can write R is equals to V by I, and the phasor diagram is like that. Both I and V are in same phase. Now power, what about power? We all know that power is equals to voltage multiplied by current. P is equals to V into I. This is our instantaneous power. Now putting the value of V and I, V derived above, V is equals to Vm sin omega t and I is equals to Im sin omega t. Putting these values, multiply by both the values. Now Vm into Im, this becomes sin square omega t. Vm into Im by 2, 1 minus cos omega t. We can write sin square 2 sin square omega t is equals to 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. Now here this is our instantaneous power. To drive average power, we know average power is equals to 1 by 2 pi and integral of p d omega t from 0 to 2 pi for a cycle. So putting the instantaneous power value in that equation, instantaneous power is Vm into Im by 2 into 1 minus cos 2 omega t. So we can put omega t is equals to theta. Now these are constant values, Vm into Im. Taking constant values outside, Vm into Im multiply divided by 2 pi multiply by 2 becomes 4 pi, and 1 minus cos 2 omega t, integration of 1 minus cos 2 omega t becomes theta minus sine 2 theta by 2, and these are limitations from 0 to 2 pi. By solving this equation, we have the power is equals to Vm into Im by 2. Now we can write Vm into Im by 2 like that, Vm by under root 2 and Im by under root 2. Now Vm by under root 2 becomes RMS value of voltage, and Im by under root 2 becomes RMS value of current. So our average power becomes P is equals to V into I. Now this is our power diagram. Here we can see voltage and current both are in same phase, and the power is equals to V into I. So this was all about resistance. Now we will talk about our second element, that is, this was all about resistance. Now we have our second element, that is inductor. Now, AC through pure inductance, we have a circuit like that. Here we have an inductor connected across a voltage source like that. V is equals to Vm sin omega t, our voltage supply. We have our third element, that is capacitor. So AC through pure capacitance. Now we have a capacitor C connected across a voltage source V, that is our voltage V is equals to Vm sin omega t. This is our supply voltage. So V is equals to Vm sin omega t. So when we connect a capacitor across a voltage source, then there will be current flowing in this circuit, and the current across the capacitor is given by I is equals to C dV by dt. Now we can write the value of V is equals to Vm sin omega t. So the equations becomes I is equals to C d by dt into Vm sin omega t, and we can write that I is equals to C by differentiating this value. Vm is constant. The differentiation of sin omega t becomes omega cos omega t. So we have I is equals to Vm divided by omega 1 by omega into C into sin omega t plus 90. We can write cos omega t is equals to sin omega t plus 90. So the current becomes I is equals to Im sin omega t. Here the value Vm by 1 by omega C is equals to Im. That is our peak value of current. So the equation became I is equals to Im sin omega t plus 90. Now compare this equation with our voltage equation. Here we can see that the current leads the voltage by an angle 90 degree. And the term Im is equals to Vm by 1 by omega C. And the term 1 by omega C here is called capacitive reactance, and it is equals to Xc. So Xc is equals to 1 by omega C and is called capacitive reactance. This is our phasor diagram of capacitor. Here we can see the voltage is equals to this, and the current leads the voltage by 90 degree. Now about power. The power is equals to P is equals to V into I. This is our instantaneous power. The putting the value of V into I in this equation, we have Vm sin omega t, and putting the value of I, we have Im sin omega t plus 90. So the value becomes Vm into Im sin omega t, and putting sin omega t plus 90 is equals to cos omega t. So the term becomes Vm into Im sin omega t into cos omega t. Now we can write 2 sin omega t into cos 2 omega t is equals to sin 2 omega t. So we replace the value by Vm into Im by 2 into sin 2 omega t. Now this is our instantaneous power. Now we calculate average power. The average power is equals to 1 by 2 pi integration 0 to 2 pi into integration 0 to 2 pi of instantaneous power. So the putting the value of instantaneous power in this equation, we have 1 by 2 pi integration 0 to 2 pi Vm by 2 into sin 2 omega t d omega t. Now integrating this term and by solving this term, we have the value is equals to 0. So our average power across a capacitor becomes 0. We have 0 average power across a capacitor, but we have instantaneous power across a capacitor pulsate at double the frequency. So the power will be positive. So the positive power means storage of electrical energy in the form of electrostatic energy across the capacitor, that we call charging. And negative power is called release of electrostatic energy back to the capacitor through the supply, that we call discharging. So this was all about basic three elements of our AC circuits: resistance, inductor and capacitance. Thank you for watching the video. More details you can log on to www.gurukpu.com.